guys, Anthony Armand Ferguson Padilla, nicknamed El Cucuy, is an American professional mixed martial artist, currently competing in the lightweight division of the Ultimate Fighting Championship, in which he is a former interim UFC lightweight champion. A professional competitor since 2008, Ferguson has been with the UFC since he won the Ultimate Fighter 30. Ferguson currently holds the record for most consecutive wins in the UFC lightweight division at 12. Toney Ferguson is not your typical mixed martial artist. He doesn't have a defined style inside the octagon. Outside the cage, he speaks freely and openly, with little care of how the fans and media perceive him. Structure? Ferguson doesn't see or know what that means. If the majority of the UFC roster is laying down a 4-4 beat, Ferguson isn't tied to a state the signature. He is free jazz. Ferguson's fighting style is anomalous. He's confusing and messy to those that can't grasp what he's putting down. He fights in a free-flower manner, but not so generic. Keep it flowing, he reacts. You don't know what angles he's going to take or in what manner he's going to attack. He doesn't work with a set timing. His rhythm is offbeat and unorthodox. But he's always driving forward, pushing forward something only he can see. Ferguson seems to know exactly where he is headed at all times. Even if no one else can quite wrap their head around where the destination is or the road he's going to take to get there. But is El Cucuy really so scary as most people think? There were 3 losses in his professional MMA career, which we now recall. Number 1, 2009, Darabedyan, unanimous decision, all-star boxing, caged in the canon event, California, USA. This is the only video of the fight that has not preserved. It is only known that it went in the format of 3 3-minute rounds and ended with an undisputed decision in favor of the Armenian fighter Karen Darabedyan. Number 2, 2009, Jamie Toney, technical submission, triangle choke, National Fight Alliance MMA, MMA at the Hyatt 3, California, USA. The video of a fight in a very bad quality, but it's better than nothing. From the very beginning, Toney outplayed Ferguson, both in the fight and in the number of takedowns. Although Ferguson certainly had moments, but Toney nevertheless managed to free himself from this heavy grip and put his feet on El Cucuy's neck, locking them into a dead triangle. Toney Ferguson fell asleep from asphyxiation on the 3rd minute of a fight. Number 3, 2012, Michael Johnson, unanimous decision, UFC on Fox, Diaz vs. Miller, New Jersey, USA. Then I seen that the former NCAA wrestler would arrange a grapple match, but Johnson was surprised when he worked in a stunt. Toney from the first minutes captured the center of the cage and tried to work the first number, but could not adapt to the defensive style of the opponent. Ferguson put a powerful puncher, which often did not reach the target, and Michael worked great as a counterpunch. Now everyone knows Toney as one of the best kickboxers in the UFC. He has a variety of punches and perfect timing. But then Johnson reworked Ferguson precisely in timing. At the end of the fight, Toney missed almost every shot. Of course you can say that Toney broke his arm and all that. But who is to blame? Toney can break his arm in every battle, so what? Well, I think that everyone understood what I mean. Lowlight TV was with you. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more lowlights.